ओके सो लेट अस कम बैक टू आवर हर्जियन डाइपोल द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ टुडेज लेक्चर। आई गेव यू ए क्लास वर्क, आई होप यू हैव सॉल्व्ड इट। दोज हु हैव नॉट सॉल्व्ड इट और दोज हु हैव सॉल्व्ड इट कंपेयर इट विद दिस सॉल्यूशन। ई इज इक्वल टू 1/j ओमेगा एप्सिलॉन 0 म्यू 0 डाइवर्जेंस ऑफ ग्रेडियंट ऑफ डाइवर्जेंस ऑफ ए प्लस के स्क्वायर ए। सो फॉर ए नाउ आई विल पुट जे ओमेगा म्यू 0 पी जी आर। सो इफ आई पुट दैट फॉर ए दिस द फर्स्ट लाइन बिकम्स डाइवर्जेंस ऑफ डेल डॉट जे ओमेगा म्यू 0 पी जी आर प्लस के स्क्वायर जे ओमेगा म्यू 0 पी जी आर। नाउ फ्रॉम दैट आई विल टेक जी आर ऑन बोथ दिस साइड्स कॉमन। So this becomes the first part becomes 1/ε0y j omega mu 0 is in the numerator and denominator for both the terms. So that I cancelled out 1/ε0 divergence of grad of p g r. Why p g r? Grad of p g r. That you can see from the above equation I have cancelled out j omega mu 0. Similarly plus k 0 p g r. Let me take g r common. If I take g r common, it becomes 1/ε0 divergence of sorry grad of p dot del, because del will not operate on p, but del is a vector, p is a vector. So p dot del plus k square p g r, right? So this is the solution for e. This is how you can find out e. We had found out H, now we have found out E as a solution to your classwork. Now in this, if you look at this, there is a gradient of GR. First term is a gradient of GR. So let me make some notes on the gradient of GR. The first thing is GR is equal to exponential minus JKR by 4 pi R, right? So it has only r dependency, no theta phi dependency, that I remember. If that is true, then my del operator is equal to r cap dou r. So grad of g r will be r cap dou r of exponential minus j k r upon 4 pi r. So I will make the derivation or derivative. I'll take the derivative. R cap is common. First, let me operate it on exponential minus jkr. So that gives me minus jk exponential j minus jkr by 4 pi. Then I will operate it on 4 pi r. So that will give me minus 1 by 4 pi r square e to the power minus jkr. So from that, and whole thing is multiplied by r cap. So that, because this gives the vector, vector is along r cap. So from this, what I can say is exponential minus j k r by 4 pi r. Let me take that common. I am left with minus j k minus 1 by r. So grad of g is equal to minus r cap of j k plus 1 by r into g r, because exponential minus j k r by 4 pi r is g r. So for grad g, I will use this expression henceforth for my Hertzian dipole. So for Hertzian dipole, let me find out what will be the E field. E is equal to 1 by j omega epsilon 0 curl of H, which will be equal to 1 by j omega epsilon 0 j omega into curl of p curl of p curl grad g, right? How do I get this? The question is, how do I get this 1 by j omega epsilon 0 curl of h? That you know, curl of h is equal to dou d by dou t plus j. J is not here in the free space or chargeless space, so curl of h is equal to dou d by dou t. So from that we get E is equal to 1 by j omega epsilon 0 curl H. Now, for curl H, for H, we are using j omega P curl or P cross grad G that we have already found. So, I am using that value for H. So, if I do that, j omega will cancel out. I will be left out with 1 by epsilon 0 into del cross P cross for grad G. We have found out an expression. What is that? Minus R cap JK plus 1 upon R GR. So this part is for P grad G. So now the third equation will be 1 by epsilon 0. This is a vector triple product. Take the vector triple product, expand it. Take a vector triple product, we will get P divergence of R cap of JK plus 1 by RGR minus P dot del operating on minus R cap JK plus 1 by RGR. So this is by taking the vector triple product using the back cap rule. A cross B cross C is equal to B of A dot C minus C of A dot B. Now only thing that you have to remember is, remember where del will operate. Del will not operate on P, del will operate on G only. So accordingly you have to put del and G together always. Now H will become J omega P cross del cross grad of GR. So that will be equal to J omega P grad of GR is equal to R cap JK plus 1 by R GR. This we know. So H is equal to this. That will be equal to J omega JK plus 1 by R into P cross R cap GR. So that I get, just I have rearrange the terms and I got H is equal to this. So this will, this is my expression for H. The expression for E will be, once I know H, I can find out E easily. 1 by J omega epsilon 0 curl of H. So curl of the above one. So this will be 1 by J omega epsilon 0 curl of J omega JK plus 1 by R into P cross R cap GR. Right, so now again we have got a vector triple product, del cross then P cross. So we have three vectors, del, P and G. We have a vector triple product. Now if we expand that vector triple product, we get E is equal to 1 upon epsilon 0 R cap to R cross JK plus 1 upon R P cross R cap into GR. So that will be one term. So that will be equal to 1 by epsilon 0 JK R plus 1 by R into, if I take this vector product, 3 R cap into R cap dot P minus P divided by K square into GR plus 1 by epsilon 0 R cap P cross R cap GR. So that will give me the final value for E, or that is my final value for E. So that is left as a homework for you to prove this, submit this homework by Friday. Next Friday is for this homework. I think I had already given one homework earlier. This is the second one. The deadline is the next Friday. Today is Monday. Coming Friday is the deadline for these homeworks. Now let us change the dipole location to R0. Up to now we were seeing the dipole is at origin. If we change it to the R0, then PR will be P impulse at R is equal to R0, which means impulse of R minus R0. That is one. Second is R cap instead of r cap, it will become capital R cap, where capital R is equal to r minus r zero. What is r zero? R zero is the location of the dipole or location of the source. So g r, g small r or g little r will be transformed to g capital R. Now all these will not affect the field. Even if we change the location to r zero, the fields are not going to be affected. This is the beauty of using the spherical coordinate system. Sometime else we will discuss this, why we use the spherical coordinate system. It leaves the fields unaffected irrespective of my origin. Wherever I put my origin of the coordinate system, the fields are unaffected. Sometime else we will discuss that. So but this will happen. So for the Hertzian dipole, remember this equation. This is the equation for the E field. Now consider the cases. First case will be if k is equal to zero. If k is equal to zero in this equation, above equation will become proportional to 1 upon r square, because in the last term we have k square, that will be zero. In the first term jk, that will be zero. So we are left with 1 by epsilon 0 into 1 by r something in the numerator by r into gr. Now we have r square into gr. Gr is 1 upon r e to the power j omega or e to the power j k r by r. Therefore denominator is r cube. So we have a r cube term when k is equal to 0, which means if k is equal to 0, we will get static field. I hope you remember from the college days that if you have a dipole, the field, static dipole, if you have a dipole, then at a distance r, the field varies as 1 upon r cube. That is for static case. So k is equal to 0 gives us static fields. There will be no radiation in this case. Then if we have radiated fields, when we'll have radiated fields, the terms will be decreasing as 1 by r. That will give me my radiated field. Right. Now here we have three terms. One first term is jk into gr. Gr has 1 upon r. So that is responsible for radiation. Last term is gr is 1 upon r. The first term is 1 upon r into gr. So r square. So that is not responsible for radiation. Then there is r cube. That is not responsible for radiation. The last term is responsible for radiation because gr is equal to e to the power minus jk r by r. So that is the term which is responsible for radiation. So and the near field is the other terms, non-radiating term, the first term, the first gr term, that gives me the near field. So that is non-radiating. They drop faster than 1 by r because they drop as 1 by r cube and 1 by r square. This is important. This near field is important. It is a new area which is called near field scanning or near field probing. What happens here is people, or we have designed, as scientists or engineers, we have designed nanometer sized dielectric tips which are constructed from tapered fibers, optical fiber if you are reading. Then you know, from optical fibers, tapering the fiber, we design dielectric tips whose size is of the order of nanometer. They act as tiny dipoles which can be used to probe evanescent fields, which is non-radiating fields or near fields from the object. Now once we do that, once we scan the evanescent fields or non-radiating fields from an object, then we are required to go near the object. When we go near the object, we get the evanescent fields as well as the radiated fields. So that results in a dramatic increase by a factor of about 10 of the resolution of microscopy, optical microscopy or electromagnetic microscopy, which is beyond the Rayleigh diffraction limit. And this is down to atomic scale. Therefore, using a near field tubing or near field scanning, we can increase the resolution by 10 times at least. So up to now, what we have done is we have found out the radiated field, total field for the Hertzian dipole, from which we can exclude the near field or the induction field, and we can find out the radiation field, which is the last term or which is the 1 upon R term. So H rad for the H field, H rad will be J omega J K P cross R cap G R, which will be J J minus 1. So minus omega square K, that R cap cross P, we can interchange, so it becomes P cross R is equal to minus R cap cross P. So minus K square becomes K square upon eta square epsilon 0 R cap cross P exponential minus J K R by 4 pi R. That comes from G R. Similarly, for E radiation, we will get K square by epsilon 0 R cap cross P cross R cap into G R. Right? So that also, if we simplify, can write as K square by epsilon 0 R cap into P cross R cap. For G, we write exponential minus J K R by 4 pi R. If we compare these two, H rad and E rad, in the radiation zone, in the radiation field, we get eta 0 H rad is equal to R cap E rad. Just look at that. Compare both these. In both these cases, we have R cap cross P e to the exponential minus jkr by 4 pi r. Cancel them out. So what is left? R cap cross E rad. H cap H rad is equal to R cap cross E rad. That's all. So eta 0 H rad is equal to R cap cross E rad. So that is the relationship between E and H field in the radiation zone. This is not valid in the near field or induction zone. So remember this. This is valid only in the radiation zone. This relationship eta 0 H rad is equal to R cap cross E rad is valid only in the radiation zone. I think we have covered everything on Hertzian dipole today. Next class, we will see an example of Hertzian dipole. We'll have more insight into Hertzian dipole in the next class.